Hey everybody, this is Andrew from Studio Network Solutions, and I'm here with a quick ShareBrowser tip to show you how you can use the ShareBrowser panel and a feature called Search Bins in Adobe Premiere to make your projects more organized. So if you haven't already, head over to the Adobe Exchange and download the ShareBrowser extension for Adobe Premiere and After Effects. This extension is going to give you a much better way to search and preview clips and then bring your files and metadata straight from your Evo server and ShareBrowser right into your project. So once it's installed, you can open ShareBrowser from your window and then extension dropdown. And we'll go over here now and log into our Evo. So I'm working on a short marketing video for a local restaurant, and I've already used ShareBrowser to tag all of my footage and audio files with various keywords. So I'm going to go over here to my bin view, and I'm going to select my restaurant video bin that already contains all of the media, audio files, and any still images that I might need for this project. So let's grab some files, and I'm going to start importing them. As my files are coming in, let's talk a little bit about search bins. Search bins are basically smart folders that are automatically going to group your assets based on specific metadata. So once you've created a search bin, clips matching that criteria are automatically grouped into a new bin, even if they're scattered across your project or already inside of another bin. Now, one of the cool things about using these is that they don't actually duplicate or move any of the media in your project, so it's not going to take up any more storage and it's not going to create a bunch of duplicate clips. Premiere is really just creating a reference or a shortcut to that file. And it's just a really powerful way to group your footage and stay organized. So now that my files are in, we'll go down here and we'll click the folder with the little search icon. And then we're going to select description from the first dropdown. So the description field in Premiere is where your ShareBrowser tags are mapped. So I'm going to start by creating one for chefs, do one for music, one for B-roll, and then one for our sound effects. So on a side note here, you can actually use up to two variables to create a search bin. For example, you can have a description, which would use your ShareBrowser tags, and or another metadata field like log notes, which would use your ShareBrowser comments. So as you can see, my sound effects folder right now only has three files in it. But when I bring new assets into my project, they'll automatically be added into the appropriate bin. So now we have this really cool way to use ShareBrowser metadata inside of a Premiere project. The great thing about this is that your ShareBrowser tags and comments are universal. You only have to enter them once, and then they'll follow your files basically throughout the entire life cycle of that file. They'll transfer in between different projects. You can use them inside of other production applications, and they're shared with everyone on your team and never really trapped inside of a specific project file. So I hope you've enjoyed this quick ShareBrowser tip. Leave a comment if you're already using search bins in Premiere or if this is the first time you're hearing about it, and let us know what you think, because we would love to hear what you would like to see next.